I were just about to... What is it, Squeaks? What do you hear? A bird? Oh yeah, I hear it too. I recognize that. That's a starling. That one sounds like it's on its own, but starlings sometimes fly in huge, and I mean huge, flocks. Now, it may be hard to believe, but at one time, there were none of these birds in the United States. Nope. Not a one. But that's not the case now at all. There are millions of starlings in the United States, and they can cause some problems. For example, starlings like to eat fruit, and if a huge group of starlings gets into an orchard, well, they can eat or harm a lot of the fruit that people need. Starlings are an example of what's called an invasive species, a type of animal or plant or other living thing that gets moved to a place where it doesn't belong and causes some harm to the other types of living things that are already there. A species is a specific kind of living thing, and lots of species can only survive in certain places. For example, a spider monkey that lives in the wet rainforest isn't going to be able to live in the dry desert. It wouldn't be able to find the food, water, and shelter it needs to stay alive. But invasive species can survive in places other than where they originally live. And when they move in, they can cause problems for the other types of living things that aren't as flexible. That's what happened with the starlings in North America. About 130 years ago, someone brought a group of starlings to the United States from England, one of the places where they naturally live. Like many other birds, starlings use their beaks to find and get food. But starlings have beaks that are extra strong, and they're so good at getting food that they can often get more food than other kinds of birds. So the group of starlings from England were able to get more food than the other birds that were already living in the United States. And the starlings were also able to get food all winter. The birds that were already here never had to deal with anything like that before. The starlings were getting and eating a lot of the food, and they weren't leaving much for the birds that were already here. When other kinds of birds went to other places to find food, the starlings moved into their nest that they left behind. When it got warmer again and the birds came back, the starlings had taken away the other birds' food and their houses. Then the starlings had babies, and their babies had more babies. The number of starlings grew and grew until there were tons of starlings and a lot less of the birds that were already living there. All this happened because one person brought starlings into the United States. Other times, invasive species move from one place to another accidentally. For example, the brown tree snake was accidentally taken from its home in Australia to a nearby island called Guam. Scientists think the snake might have been hiding on a ship or even on an airplane. Once the snakes got into Guam, they found lots of food to eat, like birds and small lizards. And while there were lots of animals for the snakes to eat, there were not very many animals on Guam that would eat the snakes. So the number of brown tree snakes started to grow. And the more snakes there were, the more birds and other animals got eaten. Some of the birds that were on Guam before those snakes got there are all gone now. So what can we do to stop invasive species? Well, it's not an easy problem to solve. Sometimes just paying attention is enough. For example, people have trained dogs to use their noses to check for tree snakes in ships and planes to make sure they don't accidentally get taken to other islands. Squeak says he doesn't smell any tree snakes in here either. Good to know. In general, people try to be very careful not to take wild animals and other living things from one area and let them go in another. The starlings in North America are probably here to stay, but we can use what we've learned from their story to stop other living things from becoming invasive species. Hey, it sounds like our starling friend took off. Maybe he went to go find the rest of his flock. And it's time for us to get going too. Thanks for joining us. If you want to keep learning and having fun with Squeaks and me, hit the subscribe button, and we'll see you next time here at the Fort.